Tavis Smiley, in particular, basically got canceled for criticizing Obama. And this is early on. I mean, this is, I mean, he got put out the barbecue and out the cookout early on. And I thought that was a signal to everybody else, particularly in the black media.
I mean, that's one of the first steps to wisdom. Mm. First step is to acknowledge God, that he is good and he is just. And from there, all other wisdom comes through.
Yeah, I mean, Jason, I would be surprised if listeners under the age of 30 even know who Tavis Smiley is.
And so one of the characters that was on the periphery that would show up from time to time was Barry Sotoro. And essentially you're talking about a guy, you know, as mentally ill as we see Barry today, his brain was already sprung back then too.
Nothing sacred.
Nothing sacred?
It's all for sale.
Ain't nothing sacred around here.
But think about it.
Yeah.
I'll be at my office at Trump Tower.
Good.
Yeah, let me off the Trump Towers, baby.
Trump Tower, this is Donald.
Gene, this is a man of great genes. His name is Gene. He has good genes, though, you know. Yeah. He's got good genes, right? The Scalia genes.
Gene Scalia, good bloodlines. Gene Scalia.
A man named Henry Ford, good bloodlines. Good bloodlines. You believe in that stuff? You got good blood. He is a very intense individual. Like, that's the bloodlines, you know, from this family. And boy, that's the father we have.
Look what it's come to. Crooks that are run jewels and holy books that only took from truth. As the earthquake shakes and tornado blows, the hurricane comes and floods the roads. Mother Nature herself speaks out through the weather. Revelations are now. Get your house together.
Hope you don't mind sharing a cab.
Oh, no, no problem. It's just right up ahead here on Fifth Avenue.
This street has changed a lot in 30 years.
So where are you going?
A broker's meeting. New York realtors.
Oh, well, you know there's going to be a lot of money made in real estate in the future.
Really? Where?
Well, I bet there are going to be a lot of taller buildings all around here. And, might even be some big glass tower right there next to Tiffany's.
There you go.
Come on, Donald.
Hello, Mr. Trump.
Trump?
See ya.
Maybe it's just something you have. You know, you have the winning gene.
My uncle was a great professor and scientist, engineer, Dr. John Trump at MIT.
Good genes, very good genes, okay?
One of the smartest people in the history of MIT, in my blood.
You believe in genes? Some do, some don't. But I had an uncle who was a professor at MIT.
Believe me, if it's good genes, we believe in genes, right? We're allowed to say. Do we believe in the gene thing? I mean, I do, right? You know, I do.
Tesla!
Sorry, Tesla? What Tesla?
Why Tesla?
Tesla!
Tesla's lap.
Lose ahead, know what I'm saying? I ain't at all worried. I ain't in a hurry. My vision ain't blurry, huh? Know what I'm saying? Of course I brought back up. Just bring the track up. I didn't come to act up. I just come to rhyme. All the rhymes I stack up, I'm tipping. All the rhymes I'm ripping. I'm flipping in my mind every time. The campground's Trump tight, hands down. You know we go Trump type, chance to clown. Rally round the home team, Scorpion and Wolverines. Play a little team ball, pass it around. Rally round the home team, rally round the home team. The campground's Trump type, hands down. Rally round the home team, rally round the home team. The campground's Trump type, hands down. It's hot where they cook at, not everybody looks out. Take but don't put back, not every girl puts out. Put up or shut up, it's hard when it's tough love. But you gotta suck it up, walk the route, chalk it up. Talk is cheap, my thoughts are deep. Keep one eye open, never caught asleep. Be junkie, be jonesing for tracks. Say a rhyme to him, then lay him on wax. Rain ball in the day, all night long. All the time, you might be like that song. Rally round the home team,
you sweat. And I guess the oldest culture they say is Egypt at 8,000.
So this is your original form, right? Yeah, it really is.
就我们这些人也是原来的人，黑头发，黄皮肤，传承下来的，我们叫龙的传人。
Prototype Death Ray.
He likes the Death Ray.
The doggy Death Ray.
Wow.
Mini drones on approach to Trump Tower.
Oh, and meanwhile.
Hey guys, so I wanted to continue my video on the Hawaii Dragon Ley Line and some of the Masonic symbols and geomancy that is in Hawaii.
Hello people, I'm Ginny Metherell and I'm a fourth generation witch.
Where are we, Trump Tower?
I was reading this Feng Shui book and it's called Lightning the Eyes of the Dragon, which gave me the next piece to this part of the puzzle. And really this is a script that I see. It's like rewriting a script, rewriting a spell, casting a spell, and that they've done it with the landmarks, with the buildings and temples and statues. And I'm sharing this so that we can all actively participate and understand what kind of script that they're trying to write.
Today's video, we're going to look at ley lines. So of course, the question is, what is a ley line? There has been a lot written, recently especially, about ley lines. They apparently were first written about by Alfred Watkins, but he just produced a treatise on what he saw as ley lines, and he thought that they were pathways, ancient pathways through which the Earth's magical power ran. Now, for those of us who have studied ley lines, and I understand ley lines to be a sort of river of Earth's magical power.
There's a interesting trident figure here. This is the United States Federal Building and IRS Building, and there's a giant medallion of the all-seeing eyes, the same symbolism that you see behind the US dollar. That
doesn't actually speak.
Then when he, in the book, it also showed that in America, America's landscape also resembled a dragon, and the tail was in New York, the financial district, and the head was in LA, California. In this situation here, we have these two dragons of East and West fighting to possess the pearl, which is a Hawaii, and it has something to do with an external possession and also an internal possession, from what I understand. In Hawaii, there's a rich mythology of the mo'os, which are the Hawaiian version of dragons. And through talking to some of the elders and the kahunas here, you know, some even would say that the Hawaiians are descendants from the dragons, and that when they talk about genealogy, it's mo'o ke hau, or when they talk about their grandchildren, it's mo'o something, or when they talk about their stories, it's called mo'o lelo, the stories that's been passed down into them. So there seems to be a lot of dragon theme coming up, and it seems to be one of the oldest mythology in our creation story. So this well-known feng shui master was hired to do the feng shui for Hong Kong, and he said the mountainscapes of China resembled a dragon, and the head was in Hong Kong.
That's great.
There's nothing sacred.
Nothing is ever over.
which is really interesting because now we have these two dragons in the Ring of Fire, and in the middle of the Ring of Fire we have Hawaii, which is a pearl, and we have Pearl Harbor, where the East Dragon, controlled by Japan at that time, fought with the Western Dragon over control of the pearl. And here is a shot of the pearl for you. Here's the dragon with the pearl. Dragons are always shown chasing after the pearl. The pearl represents their power, their wisdom, their strength. And
one thing I have noticed is that when I visit ley line crosses, if they are near, you know, a druid period settlement, then there tend to be a lot of earthbound spirits there. And there was this system where the druids of a tribe, if they lived near a ley line cross, which they most likely did, the druid would cast a spell that would last for the period of his lifetime. This spell meant that anybody in the tribe who died, their spirit was then tethered to the ley line intersection point.
Here is a picture of that. Facing the state capital, still in that eye right there. Directly in line with that, right here, is the King Kamehameha statue, separated by King Street. Here's a picture of that statue. There it is.
She's been to Lanai many times, all things Hawaii, and the people of Hawaii. Yes. She's been to Lanai
But it is interesting that the standing stones in the stone circles seem to be activated at certain times of the year. I don't know when these times of the year is. Presumably the people who built them in tune with the moon and the stars and the sun and the earth. And so therefore there'll be a time when those stones become even greater in their power conducting.
It's just, you have to force behaviors. And if you don't force behaviors, whether it's gender or race or just any way you want to say the composition of your team, you're going to be impacted.
Hawaii, the mo'os are known as guardians and protectors of the water, even in the east. Or in Tibet, in Mongolia, the Nagas, or India, the Nagas or the dragons were known as guardians and protectors and controllers of the weather and the water.
Now we're learning that scientists and researchers are looking at how to change the weather on purpose. That's right, lasers now could one day manipulate rain and lightning.
Well, instead of doing a rain dance, we physicists are firing trillion-watt lasers into the sky to actually precipitate rain clouds and actually bring down lightning bolts. This is potentially a game changer. Governments have been playing with this thing.
Alleged to,
right. Yeah. Now,
this has been proven. The scientific tests have been done. And at one point, they were looking at these roll white stones, I think. And the roll white stones started emitting ultrasonic sound waves and electromagnetic power. So obviously there is something going on. We just don't know what it is. I reckon myself, having spent quite a lot of time with them, I think they were using these as magnifiers of this Earth's magnetic, magical power. And then whatever they wanted to do, be it, you know, have a group crop harvest, anoint a king, ensure that their tribe was the best tribe in the region, they would use these stone circles to perform their rites and get that magical power. I mean, that's what I presume they were doing.
Their broader ideas at work.